Hello again, this is Scott Workman, and the reason for this video is going to be totally different than all the ones about my dog. I appreciate everybody watching them, but as I've noticed all the views, I thought this might be a good time to get another issue out there, and that issue is texting while driving. As you can see in the video, I'm driving right now, and I have my phone sitting up in my window, and both my hands are free. I'm not texting, I'm just driving and talking. But I want to touch on the issue of why the hell is everybody texting and driving? Is it really that important? Hey, I drove around yesterday and just seen so many people texting. I seen kids texting, and God forbid, kids already have a reaction time slower than adults. And on top of that, they've got their hand on a text message, and they're reading it, and they're looking down, they're driving. Just 3 days ago, out on US 33 coming towards Salina, a lady crossed into my lane and I had to move because she came into my lane and she was so close that I could see her BlackBerry. Listen, people, it's not worth dying over. You know, you can get that message later. Talking, I can completely understand that. You know, I run a small business and I have to talk on the phone, and I have an earpiece that I use to do that with. But for those of you who know me, you know that while I'm driving, I am not going to text message you. So if you send me a text while I'm in the truck or I'm driving, it's not going to happen. I'm not going to message you back. I'm not in the mood to be dying because you want to receive a text message from me. If it's that important, call me. And if I can, or if I'm in a position to answer the phone, I will. But listen, people, especially parents out there, you got to convey this to your kids. Don't lose your children to a text message. I mean, I know we need to know where everybody's at. You want to know where your kids are at. I completely agree with all that. But these kids are out here texting, and adults, we're not doing any better. I mean, I've done it myself. I remember some time ago, I used to text message, and I drifted across the line. You know, it's probably been, you know, 7 or 8 months ago. But it's just not worth it, man. I mean, what are we going to do? Wait till people start dying regularly? You know, we've already lost people to the cell phone. We've already lost a number of children. We've already lost a number of adults. And what day do we change it? When do we finally say, you know what, finally enough is enough? I mean, we're a society where it has to happen before we take action. We're not a society that says, you know what, let's do preventative. We'll do preventative maintenance on our cars and change the oil, but we don't want to do preventative maintenance on ourselves as people. You know, the great technology, we get to keep up with each other, and all of you are in your 30s or so. You guys, you know, you remember when we used to have to wait by the phone for somebody to call. You know, the kids these days, they don't know nothing about that. The 16 and 17-year-olds, all they've ever known is these cell phones. So they're not like us and had to sit by the phone and wait on your buddy to come pick you up. Nowadays, everything's so fast-paced that we can't miss a minute, or we can't miss a second checking Facebook, or you got to post something. It's just getting out of control. I mean, we live in a small town here of Salina, Ohio. And I've been up to the bigger cities. You know, we go to Cincinnati and Dayton and Cleveland, and it's even worse than what it is around here. Everybody's got a cell phone in their hand, and it looks like it's super glued there. They're walking around texting, driving texting, out on 70, they're texting, 75. You can drive by anybody. I mean, is it really that important to try to kill somebody? Or those of you who think that you can drive and you know right where the buttons are, so it's okay for you to text. No, it's not. It's absolutely not, because even though you can text when you're looking the other way, like you can type and look away, you can't read and look away. So I know good and well you're taking your eyes off the road. You know, and I'm driving on this road, and a lot of other people are on these roads. The point I'm trying to make here today is just quit. I mean, wait till you get where you're going. If it's that important, pull over. Or if you got somebody in the car with you, hand it to them and let them text about it. I mean, if it's that fucking important, just do that. Just hand it over. Don't keep doing this, people. I mean, I don't know to what degree we've got to go to. How many people got to die or get hurt before we finally say enough is enough? I mean, it's just a little issue. I'm nobody important, you know. But I thought, since so many people have been watching these dog videos, I'd get this out here. See, I'm driving a truck right now. It's a stick shift. I got my phone up in the window and it's recording, and we don't have any problem whatsoever. But the whole texting thing, it's got to stop at some point. You know, I'm hoping not to read in the newspaper that we lost somebody because they were texting. I mean, it's so useless. Why are we doing it? Parents, I mean, you gotta know. I mean, but you're doing the same thing that your kids are doing. You know how hard it's gonna be to tell your kids don't do it when they're thinking, mom or dad, you're doing exactly what I'm doing. You're driving home from work and you're texting your kids, or you're texting your husband wanting to know what's for dinner. You know, it's gonna be a real sad day for somebody to have to say, you know what, your wife or your child or your husband was texting when you lost them, or when we crossed that line and got hit head on by another vehicle, or God forbid a semi, or, you know, we run off the ditch and roll a vehicle. You know, you guys from Salina and around this area of Rockford, you know, we've just lost a young person just recently to an auto accident. So where do we draw the line, people? I mean, just stop. I mean, it's not rocket science. Just quit. There's no need to be texting and dying. There's no you don't text and even take the chance. Just pull over. I mean, if you're in that big a hurry, text when you get where you're going. It's just going to be a shame to be on the other end of that. I don't want to be on the other end of that when they tell me that someone close to me is dead and gone because they were trying to send a text message to somebody. I'm hoping some of you understand what I've said today, and maybe one or two of you will quit texting, or at least give it some thought, or text less or something. But it's going to be a sad, sad day when we lose somebody because of it. And then you have to live with that the rest of your life. I don't personally want to be the one to have to live with something like that. So it's just a message, you know. Hopefully some of you will pay attention. And I'm Scott Workman, and that's my message for the day. Thanks.